Recently, Razer have released yet another update for automobiles dazu. It has now been updated from version 1.0.5.1 to version 1.0.5.5. So, first of all, I have bad news for you. The Nürburgring is no longer part of Automobilista 2. But, fortunately, I also have some good news for you. It is actually still in the game, but you have to purchase it in the Steam store, where it is located as the Nürburgring Track Pack on Automobilista 2's shop page. This track pack also includes the current layout of the Nordschleife, but a combined track layout is not in the game yet. Razer have stated though that they are planning on releasing a combined layout later this month as an addition for the Nürburgring track pack for free. Also, a historic version of the Nordschleife is currently in works and can be expected in 2021. Another point for this update is a general overhaul for the physics of all GT cars that were released in the last patch. This includes all GT3 cars, all GT4 cars, as well as the Porsche Cup cars. However, to get these new physics to work correctly, you need to reset all of the affected cars to their respective default setups. Even though those changes were marketed as quite major by Razer themselves in the update log, I honestly didn't feel too much of a difference. It's probably fair to say that the core driving characteristics of all affected cars stayed the same, but were slightly improved for edge of the grip scenarios. So next time before you hit the track, be sure to revert back to the car's respective default setup in order to experience these changes to their full volume. In addition to the physics tweaks, a lot of individual values for the GT3 and GT4 cars have also been adjusted. These include the BOP, tire treads, power curves, as well as suspensions, which is mostly noticeable in the GT4 Porsche Cayman. As this is basically it for the more significant changes for this update, let's talk about Razer's implementation of the Nordschleife for AMS2. Now, the first thing I noticed when driving on Nordschleife was that it somehow felt familiar, but actually not quite. When speaking about track characteristics like bumpy sections or uphill and downhill sections, the implementation in Automobilista 2 almost completely resembles the one in Project Cars 2. What sets these two apart is mostly Automobilista 2's superior physics. In Project Cars 2, the track was all slippery and a snap oversteer could basically happen at any point in time. What negatively stood, or rather stands still out about Project Cars 2, is its weird and arbitrary behavior of the curbs. Interestingly enough, this is not the case for its implementation of the Nordschleife, where all curbs were usable at all times, whereas other simulations, which are mostly considered as more realistic, like R-Factor 2 or Assetto Corsa, would instantly punish you for abusing the wrong curbs. Now, as we all know, Automobilista 2 is quite different to Project Cars 2 when it comes to curbs. However, with regards to the Nordschleife and its higher curbings, they are basically the same. You are free to take any curb you want, as both games are, at least on this track, very lenient when it comes to punishing curb abuse. AMS2's implementation is still challenging to drive, but not quite as exciting or rather nerve-wracking as other implementations. This does not mean, however, that it's not fun to drive. Heck, GT Sport's version of the Nordschleife is actually the most fun to drive, since you can just cruise through the track and use its full width everywhere. So what I'm saying is basically that AMS2's implementation is quite a bit easier to drive, which doesn't force you to be 100% concentrated all the time, and therefore allows for a more laid-back experience. So in the end, I'd say Automobilista 2's Nordschleife is a decent middle ground between the hardcore version of R-Factor 2 and GT Sport's implementation. Now, this is the point where I initially planned on ending this video, but somehow Razer decided to launch another update out of nowhere at the time where I'm recording this. This update basically contains a lot of quick hotfixes for the previous update I just talked about, but also one rather significant change. Do you remember when I said earlier that Riza are planning on adding a 24-hour layout for the combined Nordschleife and Nürburgring GP track? Well, in this hotfix, they already did so. So yeah, this is basically it for this video, and if you enjoyed it or could get something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one.